We have surveyed over 1,500 leading entrepreneurs across the G20 countries to explore what entrepreneurs, policymakers, and other stakeholders can do to promote entrepreneurship. The overarching feeling coming out of the EY G20 Entrepreneurship Barometer 2013 is that it's all about the power of three. Specifically, how together governments, entrepreneurs, and corporations can spur growth across the G20. But why should we invest in entrepreneurship? Perhaps because entrepreneurs create jobs, support communities, and build economies. In China, entrepreneurs provide 75% of all jobs, and in 2012, they supplied 67% of all jobs in the EU. It takes an entrepreneur to change an idea into reality. And by commercializing innovations, entrepreneurs drive investment that can give an economy the edge. In fact, 74% of entrepreneurs said they hired more people over the past year as a result of their company's innovations. Maria Pinelli, Global Vice Chair of Strategic Growth Markets at EY, also agrees. Boosting entrepreneurship is one of the most powerful things policymakers can do to support the economy. It creates jobs and the rapid growth companies of the future, upon which long-term national growth prospects ultimately depend. The barometer ranks each G20 country across five pillars that together are essential in the fostering of an entrepreneurial ecosystem. The first pillar of the barometer is access to funding. 7 out of 10 entrepreneurs said they struggled to gain access to funding, but it's not all bad news. The EY Guide to Funding Entrepreneurial Businesses highlights the need for the right capital at the right time in a company's life cycle. Innovative forms of finance are emerging, with 49% of entrepreneurs noticing an improvement in the availability of crowdfunding. Have you seen that too? The next pillar is entrepreneurship culture. What we know is that governments must work to remove the stigma of failure, especially in countries like Italy, where business failure is viewed as a particularly negative experience. Entrepreneurs are spending too much time and money caught up in tax and regulation. They accept that taxes are here to stay, but as Chris Sanger, Global Tax Policy Leader at EY, states, entrepreneurs are willing to pay taxes that vary as they make profits. However, paying fixed taxes frustrates and poses problems, especially when it stunts the growth of startups. 84% of entrepreneurs across the G20 want taxes to be simplified. What do you think? Across the G20, there appears to be a lack of entrepreneurial education and training. Perhaps all G20 governments should follow Lithuania, Romania, and Poland and make a specific course in entrepreneurship mandatory in school. 84% of entrepreneurs we spoke to thought education supporting entrepreneurial skills and attitudes was essential. Our last pillar looks at coordinated support, where the idea of clustering related industries and institutions in close proximity to create a thriving environment for entrepreneurs came to the fore. Many G20 countries do this, and over 50% of entrepreneurs believe access to clubs and associations has improved. We'll be exploring each pillar one by one in more detail on ey.com/G20EY, where you'll be able to offer your opinion and debate the issues with others. Join the debate at ey.com/G20EY or find us on LinkedIn and Twitter and make your voice heard.